Now, over the years, I've realized that there are three fundamental skills that you need to have as you approach this whole problem space of designing for immersive 3D virtual reality or mixed reality environments. And these three skills are storytelling, improv, and imagineering. Let's break down each one of these and unpack them one by one. In terms of storytelling with VR, it's absolutely essential that you understand how important of a design tool this is. But storytelling mechanics can be brought into serious or consumer VR pieces just the same. Just to back up on story, if you're not familiar with story, there's something called a story arc. Story arc is used by filmmakers and storytellers, people that write novels and work on narratives for a living. And the way the story arc goes is you start out with what's called the exposition, or kind of a little bit about what's going on. Usually there are characters involved. And then that character kind of, this is what's called the rising. As it rises, there's some kind of conflict or tension there with the character, with the hero. It's also called the hero's journey. And the character might run into problems and obstacles, and then they figure out the solution, something comes in their way, they unlock the prize, and they live happily ever after. And that's basically the story arc. What that looks like in VR, though, is a lot faster and more collapsed than you get in a book or in a movie. In a movie, you get like 90 minutes to unfold the story arc. In a book, you get maybe 200-300 pages to do that. In VR, you get like 10 minutes or maybe 20 minutes max, you know, and maybe in some cases, just a few minutes. So using the story arc in immersive media is a little bit different. It means you have to move quickly. And why do we use storytelling? Is because storytelling narrative techniques can give the user cues. It can help spark emotions. It can guide them as they're discovering an environment. And it can also induce immersion, like it can give that deepened sense of immersion or the feeling of being there, the presence. Or it can also give them agency. So the IPA, the immersion presence or agency, that sense of control, agency, that sense of choice that they may have in the world, right, with the story. So using narrative is the key here to unfold the scene, to set the background, right? If you think of your virtual environment as a canvas, and what I call an affordance canvas. Affordance is a term we use in UX that indicates that a design can be interact with, right? So if you think of a design, for example, a handle. So if there's a handle that you pull in VR, it might be glowing. That gives it an affordance. And that's really important to give objects affordances in VR. But I'm talking about story as or narrative as to unfold the whole scene. So for example, you know, if you enter a room and you hear a clock ticking, you know, what is going on with a clock? You know, a clock could induce a sense of urgency or mystery, right? And that's what I mean. Just even sound alone, that's a narrative device, can be used. The narrative can help the task flow or the story flow. Almost think of it as a guidance system. So let's say that same clock is over in the corner and the ticking is coming from over there. And the more you get close to it, the louder it gets. It reminded me of the power of sound, particularly in VR, as a narrative device, right? So you can use sound, you can use the tension of space, so you could use characters, of course, like you can have maybe friendly, maybe threatening, you know, whatever it is appropriate for the story or the experience that you're shaping. But those narrative mechanics can be used to help you do that. If you look at Alchemy Labs, their 2022 game, Cosmonius High, it's a high school, but just to illustrate a narrative mechanic, you're entering a school and the school it's sort of a back to school thing, but then there's sort of problems in the school. That's the narrative. And the character sort of comes up to you and she's narrating and she says, and blah, 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 blah. And so how are you feeling today? And it throws up a little interface with some emojis, and you choose one of the emojis, and without missing a beat, she says, oh, that's optimistic of you, huh? And then continues to like sort of onboard you into the experience. They use gaze, they use sound, they use light and guides, arrows pointing, you know, something to grab the user's attention, something to guide you through. You shouldn't go into VR and be like, what do I do? VR is not there just to keep you curious and in a state of constant discovery. These are the most annoying VR experiences where you're just discovering, you don't know what to do, you feel stupid. That's not a good UX design for VR. Instead, you should use all the different materials and starting with those high-level goals of immersion, presence, and agency. So the story arc for VR might look like this. You start them out with what their goals might be, you motivate them, you open the scene, you give them a little emotion, like curiosity, and then you provide some affordances, some agency, would you like to, navigation, sound, visual, gaze, motion. You might introduce another emotion, right? Remember that VR is highly emotional. Technology, so emotion design is a requirement. You have to do it. If you don't do emotion in VR, you're missing a major UI element. So story, of course, is very emotional, right? So you might get up to the conflict, the tension. Maybe the conflict is just that clock. Maybe you're supposed to do a task. So that's the high point of that story arc for VR. And then the resolution might be, they finish the task. They complete it. It checks the box. Think about story as a design tool, that you've got these things in your hands called narrative mechanics. That's the narrative is a story, mechanics is what you do with it, how you pull, push. If the room, the walls get tighter, right? That's a narrative mechanic. Why are the walls getting tighter? And what you can do is story sketch. So how you do this, you'll start with brainstorming sessions, like note cards, create quick sketches, put them up on the wall. Just get your first ideas and images and feelings out as you create that story and do what's called story sketching. So you might, there are apps you can use, there are software programs for storyboarding. So you just like create that storyboard just like they would in an animation studio.